this is Abdul from Pythonist. One of the most important things in writing efficient programs is understanding the guarantees of the data structures you use. In fact, a large part of performant programming is understanding what questions you are trying to ask of your data and picking a data structure that can answer these questions quickly. In this video, we are going to explore such kinds of questions that lists and tuples can answer quickly and how they do it. Lists and tuples are a class of data structures called arrays. An array is simply a flat list of data with some intrinsic ordering. Arrays can be implemented in multiple ways. This creates another separation line between lists and tuples. So lists are the dynamic arrays, while tuples are static arrays. Let's dive a little bit deeper and unpack these previous statements a bit. System memory on a computer can be thought of as a series of numbered buckets, each capable of holding a number. These numbers can be used to represent any variables we care about, like integers, floats, strings, or other data structures, since they are simply references to where the data is located in memory. In order to look up any specific element in our list, we simply need to know which element we want and remember which bucket our data stored in. If, for example, we needed to retrieve the first element in our array, we would simply go to the first bucket in our sequence and read the value inside that. If, on the other hand, we needed the fifth element in our array, we would go to the bucket at fifth position and read its content. What if we were given an array with an unknown order and wanted to retrieve a particular element? Let's write some code. I have a list with some elements named as my underscore list. We have to find the position of a particular element, and in this case, we don't know the order of the list, so we have to do a search operation. The most basic approach to this problem is called linear search, where we iterate over every element of the list, and if it is the value we are looking for, we can return the value or its position. So let's define a function named as linear underscore search. It will take the element we want to retrieve the position for and the list. Then we will iterate over the array using enumerate method, which will return the index, which is the position of that particular element and its content. So we will write the for loop as for I item in enumerate of array, and we will check that if the current item has the content which is similar to the content of our item which we are looking for, so we can simply return the position or the index of that particular item. This algorithm has a worst case performance of big O of n. And this case occurs when we search for something that isn't in the array. In order to know that the element we are searching for isn't in the array, we must first check it against every other element. Eventually, we will reach the final return minus one statement. In fact, this algorithm is exactly the algorithm that list.index uses. Okay, so let's call this function and pass our array and try to find the position of number 42. We can notice that the 42 is at the 7th position in the array. But we can achieve better search performance if we first sort our data, so that all elements to the left of a particular item are smaller than it or larger. This comparison is done through dender equal and dender less than magic functions of the object in Python, and can be user defined when you are using custom objects. The two ingredients necessary are the sorting algorithms and the searching algorithms. Python lists have a built-in sorting algorithm that use TeamSort. TeamSort can sort through a list in big O of n in the best case, and big O of n log n in the worst case. It achieves this performance by utilizing multiple types of sorting algorithms and heuristic to guess which algorithm will perform the best. So in conclusion, we can achieve better search performance if we first sort over data so that all elements to the left of a particular item are smaller than it or larger than it. Python provides a built-in module bisect for the purpose of binary search. This module simplifies much of this process by giving easy methods to add elements into a list, to find the closest element of what we are looking for very quickly while maintaining its sorting. So let's write a function to find the closest element for a value. This can be extremely useful for comparing two datasets that are similar but not identical. So we will define a function named as find_closest, which takes the list and the value for which we want to find the closest element. Then we will call the bisect_left function, which will return the leftmost value in the list. Then I will check if we have only that element in the list and return that particular element. Otherwise, I will return the element, then we will check if we have the exact element in the array for which we are looking for. So that's the closest element definitely. Otherwise, if we have proceeded to the next value, we will take the left value by getting the previous index and saved into J. Since we know that value is larger than the our value which we are looking for and vice versa for the value at J. So we will check it if the ith value of the array minus our own value which we are looking for is greater than its next value which is at the jth, we will simply return the jth index. Otherwise, we will return the ith index simply. I know it can be a little bit difficult to understand, but we can elaborate it in much more easy way when we will utilize that function. So we have created our function, so let's create a list of random numbers. So we will define an array as numbers and take the range up to 10 by using for loop as for I in x range of 10 and just generate a list of random integers by utilizing the random module of Python and create a sorted array by utilizing the bisect.insort method. So that's great, we have created our data, so let's find the closest index in the array for a value. Let's say we are going to find the closest element in the array for the value 500. So we will simply call this find_closest method and passing the array of numbers with the value we are looking for, which is 500 in our case. And we will save the result in closest_index variable and print that out. You can see the closest element for the value of 500 here in the result. In general, this touches the fundamental rule of writing efficient code. Pick the right data structure and stick with it. So in conclusion of this video, searching and sorting are two of the most important operations to write the efficient code for lists and tuples. In the upcoming videos, we are going to elaborate the differences between lists and tuples in a very detailed way. So let's keep watching to the next video.